Now, what's his nose going up, 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 up? Or his ears coming backwards, over, backwards, over, backwards, over? That means that the puss is stronger than the forward. So one hind leg is going forward, the other one is pushing at the same moment. And if the one pushing is stronger, he will feather in his spine this way around. So this is the spine feathering down. So we must get it the opposite way around, that the spine is feathering up. That when the hind foot is stepping forward, the spine is lifting and the ears are going forward out. Step backwards up. So try to use your inside leg or whip to send at least an inside hand foot towards the hand. Yet. Yet. Good. Then the horse is coming to the hand because the underline is shortening and the upper line is stretching. That the muscles over the stomach are shortened by taking forward the hind foot, and the muscles in the upper line shall, as a reflex of this, relax. That means that these then start, will then start to stretch forward and down. And when he is then feathering correct, he will feather upwards, upwards, upwards. So it seems like a little, tiny little difference, but it's actually the 100% opposite activity of the spine. Good, there he comes. This is walking. Let him. The problem is, if such a good horse is doing just a bit walk, we are already impressed. It is the ability to see how much more this horse could do.
And the inside brain making him hollow, exactly, and then trot. Trot, trot. Okay, that the outside brain is not to stand in, making him hollow to the inside, making him hollow to the inside. The outside front leg is too far backwards, you must have a clear outside shoulder. Playing with the inside brain of his neck, that he's getting more hollow to the inside and more shoulder freedom on the outside. So first, when you can keep him in the outside brain, then first you can start to control him with the outside brain. The first outside must be outside. Bit better understanding. Inside leg forward, inside outside rein forward. Bit longer outside rein and playing on the inside. Playing on the inside, looking to give to the inside. Little half horse to the inside. He's still having the lower jaw to the wrong side. Good. Now he starts to get a bit more swinging in his back. He's using his outside front leg forward and his inside hind leg forward. So if your outside rein is too early with getting contact with the horse, you are avoiding the swinging of the spine. Now you're just going to try with your inside, the upper leg, to find the rotation of the chest. Inside upper leg, making a little pressure to his chest now, 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 now. And if you feel the rotation of the chest, you can, but you can't if you use your outside brain to avoid him being bended. He must come to your outside brain, not the outside brain coming to you. And you must accept that he has big gaze. So if he has big gaze, you cannot make them better by making them smaller. Yes. So if he has a big gaze, that is the way he's moving.
Thank you.